There is a lot of pressure in day-to-day business, but this should not be a reason to put entrepreneurial foresight on the back burner. If this were the case, you would behave like a lumberjack who has to work with a blunt chainsaw and claims that he has no time to buy a proper chainsaw because he has to cut wood. There are dependencies, which is why an ethical attitude on the part of the manager is important. Employees are always dependent on their manager. So if there is no basic ethical attitude, there is a risk of abuse of power and exploitation. The most important principle of leadership should therefore be to do no harm. Consequently, mindfulness is the key criterion of ethics. You can only develop appropriate ethics for yourself if you are aware of your role towards other people and your responsibility for your own actions. Morality versus ethics. The question arises as to how to develop appropriate ethics. It is also necessary to clarify the difference between morals and ethics. Can a person really do without ethics if they have morals? Can a person even give up any morality for a well-thought-out ethic? Just remember the ego states, norms and rules are stored in our parental ego, but these are not our ethics because we have adopted the guidelines without reflection. These are commandments and prohibitions. You could also say that it is etiquette for managers. However, their content does not come from us. People who are important to us were the suppliers. These are mainly our parents. Morality, on the other hand, is something that is followed. It is also very rigid. It is possible for a person to be very moral but have no ethics. In short, this means that with moralists, the people are there for the rules but not the rules for the people. Rules are considered absolute, which in turn is fundamentalist. When we talk about pure morality in the company, we are talking about cadaver obedience to the regiment. However, this is very dangerous for the employees as well as for the company. These moral rules of conduct have not been reflected upon in detail, which is why people have no independent opinion on them. Moral thinking works in terms of one should or one must not. This is called the adaptation of the child ego. Here, too, the existing morals have not been examined and whether the rules of conduct are actually appropriate.